Welcome back in, viewers or listeners, to another episode of Lowell Talks. In today's episode, we're going over the conversation, the elephant in the room, should you be doing work for free? Coming up next. Free work, that is the question. And to be honest with you guys, it's going to take a little bit of an explanation, but I do think you should be doing free work. And specifically, if you're just getting started. Now, hear me out. As I've been doing this now for 5 to 6 years, of course, I am trying my best to get paid for every bit of video shooting and editing that I'm doing. Now, in the beginning days, let me be the first one to tell you, I genuinely don't think I could charge people. So it put me in a situation where I needed to be doing work, I wanted to actually build my portfolio, but how in the world was I gonna get clients considering I didn't have a portfolio and my work was not that great? Now this is where we go diving into the free work conversation. Now that being said, in the beginning, my strategy was, I knew I was okay to do good enough that somebody would like the work. Now to pay for it, that's a whole different conversation. So I would typically approach people with the kind of business strategy in mind of, hey guys, let me do some video for you. Let's make it a win-win. I'm gonna do a pro bono. You guys are giving me a unique opportunity and I'm going to try my best to make, you know, your video experience as good as possible. So that kind of started the free work relationship with clients off on a note that they're kind of interested in regards to just accepting the free work, because who doesn't want free work? And then on the other end of things on my side, it kind of fosters an environment for me to go in with the understanding that I am here to impress, but at the same time, there's no money on the table. So it kind of takes the barrier to entry down a little bit. Now let's fast forward now to currently where I'm at. Do I go out kind of promoting free work? Absolutely not. But I will tell you this, as I've been doing more and more projects, the one thing I'm trying to do is diversify my portfolio. So that being mini documentaries, that being commercials, YouTube videos, product videos, I mean, the list goes on. But what I'm trying to get at is I am trying to get an opportunity to film in all those different niches. Now, so what I found my approach being is that if I really want to enter a niche, so let's say like gym videos or workout videos, but I don't have something in my portfolio to show to an actual potential client and say, look, this is what I can do for you, I will then approach them with the honest feedback of, hey, I'm pretty good with a camera, here's some of my work, show them Instagram, show them YouTube, things that are more catered to their industry, not specifically, but just enough to get them a glimpse of, okay, this individual can film. They can film well, and I think if I gave them an opportunity, they could take my business or whatever we're doing here and visually tell a great story. So that's kind of how I approach a lot of people. I basically say, hey, check out what I've been doing. I'd love the opportunity to film with you. You guys are giving me an opportunity to kind of take a step into your market, and I'm going to repay you with a wicked good video for either free or a very cut rate discount. Now, typically what happens in those kind of situations is when I kind of get that experimental client. Let's just say they're somewhat grandfathered in the fact of, because they gave me that opportunity, I am going to always kind of treat them a little bit different, because that's kind of like they scratched my back, I'm gonna scratch their back. And you know, as the relationship goes on for years and years, yes, I do charge them what I would consider what is worth my time, but I'm really not going hard after making a massive, like, you know, income off of these particular people, because in my eyes, they gave me a chance. So I am going to return the favor and say thank you and do very reasonable work for them at a very reasonable price. Because in a nutshell, they're kind of my experience. Ground. They're the people that gave me the first shot, and I'm going to stick with them and give them everything that I can at what I consider a very good price for my time and for what they are getting in return. Now, if you have been doing this for years and you are very talented, that then contradicts everything that I've said. Yes, you need to be charging. You probably don't need to be doing free work. But if you've reached that point, you're probably like myself and you're in a situation where you might have to go look for work, but also work's coming your way and you have a portfolio to justify why you would be charging certain prices. Now, if you're a beginner, like I said in the beginning, that's going to be where it needs to be your judgment call. If you think you're pretty rocking and rolling and that you're editing is up to par to receive some funds, then by all means, go full steam ahead and you need to be charging to make profit. I don't know if that's a conversation that you guys enjoyed, but free work is something that a lot of people want to ask, they want to know about. And like I said, in the beginning, I find it one of the most useful tactics to take. I think it's kind of very individual basis on how long you go down the free road. But like myself, it took many years before I started getting paid for a lot of these things. And I genuinely just needed somebody to say, absolutely, Trey, you can come into my business. You can come into my nonprofit. You can film. I kind of like what you're already doing. I'd love to see what you can do in my niche. And honestly, it's paid off big time. And it's kind of created some trust amongst current clients, former clients, probably even, you know, future clients. It just really, it brings them in from the beginning with what I'm trying to do. And I'm kind of entering this video world with them on the front end. And it's both a win-win for both the client and myself. So, hey guys, it's Trey Lowell with Lowell Talks. I don't even know what episode this is, but this is a conversation I definitely wanted to just interject in, give you guys my two cents and tell you that it's all up to you, but your videos will speak for itself, and how you deal with clients and how you price them in the long haul will really just show. And my best advice that I can give any of you guys out there is that it is not a sprint, it's a marathon. And if you can kind of get my vibe on what I'm putting there, if you treat your clients well and you deliver on everything that you've agreed upon, it will be a win-win, and this video lifestyle will be something that you can achieve and go after. And honestly, just have a good time creating and oh God, I butchered the ending. All I gotta say is do hard work, charge good prices, be reasonable, and you will succeed. I'm out.